Whoever sees this and subscribes right now will get a free washcloth. So fresh and so clean, Clay. What's going on, YouTube? It's Knox Hill, and we're back with our reaction series. So I know what you guys are thinking. You're looking at me, and it's like, man, he looks like a Calvin Klein model. I've been seeing some of the comments lately, man. I mean, honestly, most of it is overwhelmingly positive and supportive, but there's always just those few people, man. Those few people that try to get to you. So if you guys are new to the channel and checking me out, man, you know what it is. I am the professor with a PhD in barology, man. I am a rapper myself. For those of you that have been here and you know me, you know what you're getting. We're gonna put the songs under the microscope and do what we do. So today we are going to continue down the Eminem train with his brand new album, Music to be Murdered By. Now, we just did Godzilla, and let me tell you, man, that was a Godzilla-type track. He came in with a monster flow, so I thought, why not check out the next track that I know has two lyrical monsters on it? That's right, it's Royce the 5'9 and Eminem coming through with You Gonna Learn. Now, I've not heard the song yet, guys, but let me just say that I am excited to check it out because whenever Royce and M get on a track, those are two lyrical masterminds. I mean, even M has come out and said that there are not many MCs standing on this planet who he feels measure up to him. But if there is one that he should mention, it is none other than the 5'9 himself. We also got a feature on this track by White Gold. Now, I've never heard White Gold before. I'm not sure where he fits into it, so I'm looking forward to checking that out as well. So, without further ado, Eminem, Royce the 5'9, White Gold. Step up to the plate, guys. Let's see what you got. See tomorrow, little boy, you gon' learn. Wow. All them pretty bitches leave your ass in the urn. Okay. You ain't saw your last rock, you just better earn. But I pray you see tomorrow, little boy, you gon' learn. Pray you see tomorrow, little boy, you gon' learn. Wow. All them pretty bitches leave your ass in the urn. You ain't saw your last rock, you just better earn. But I pray you see tomorrow, little boy, you gon' learn. Man. That was some crazy production on that. I love that hook, man. Was that White Gold? That must have been White Gold on that. The thing was, you know, you got M on the track. You got Royce the 5'9 on the track. I'm expecting something heavy hitting, man. But that was just, that was smooth. That vibe, that had soul. And then some of that percussion that was mixed in the scratching. That was cool. That had like a little bit of a dubstep kind of feeling vibe. Like a little bit of drum and bass. But at the same time, it had that hip-hop swagger to it as well. Oh, I gotta figure out who produced that. If you guys know who produced this track, comment down below, please. I'm a product of properly hopping up out of that poverty, profiting off of copping and swapping that property out for a possible monopoly. No. We gotta rewind that back. Come on, Royce. You can't be coming in that heavy right away, man. My ears are not tuned in and ready to go on this. I'm a product of properly hopping up out of that poverty, profiting off of copping and swapping that property out for a possible monopoly. Trying not to adopt my father's old philosophy. Man, just the play on those vowels and those P's, profiting, copping, swapping that property for a possible monopoly. You know, when you play Monopoly and you trade pieces and you're trying to gain property. Man, I've never heard someone talk about coming from, you know, coming from the ghetto, coming from the inner city, and explaining his conditions in which he was raised in that way. I mean, Royce the 5'9 is so undervalued and underappreciated. This man is like, he's a hip-hop poet, man. He is a hip-hop philosopher. And all we can do is just sit back and enjoy when he gets on the mic and he starts talking. Trying not to adopt my father's old philosophies. Nah. Same time, I'm praying to God that everything works out and it's colonoscopy. Royce has come out before and talked about his dad. You know, his dad had problems with alcoholism. His dad had problems with drug abuse, but at the same time he acknowledges, you know, that his dad did the best that he could to try and raise him. So on one hand, while, you know, his dad came from these conditions and his dad was a certain way, he doesn't want to make the same mistakes as his father. But that doesn't mean he doesn't love his dad. That doesn't mean he's still not his father, and you can't take that away from him. So he's still praying that he makes it through his colonoscopy, and he still loves his dad. That's crazy deep. I'm walking across a suicidal tightrope intentionally. Wow. While the demons coming out of me, wifey's on the side of me talking sense into me. Wow. Walking on a suicidal tightrope. Wifey's on the side talking sense into me. Now, I've said this. I don't know many artists that that mention their wives, especially when it comes to rap and hip-hop. NF is one of those that comes to mind, but Royce, man, Royce is giving some mad love to his wife on this one, and respect to her. You know, she's saving him from that tightrope and the demons that are inside mentally and the things that haunt him. Without she, I feel incomplete mentally. She's been sent to me right there since 9-6. Worst nightmare to side chick. Some things are just meant to be. This it for me. Give my daughters a kiss for me. Y'all call this fame. I call this shit alcoholistic infamy. Targeting my kids and babies through population and gun control. Wow. Shit make me want to make 100 more. Make a bigger. Targeting my kids and babies through population and gun control. Now, there's some conspiracy theory for you right there. Population control. You know, conspiracy theory such as introducing AIDS into the inner cities, that was done by the government. Royce, he's getting a little bit like Immortal Technique on that, man. Okay, Royce. I mean, the thing is about Royce, you don't always have to agree with what he says or what he's thinking, but he's so good at taking a complex thought and complex idea and putting pen to the page, and he articulates these deep thoughts so well. Come on, Royce, keep going. The bigot race is uncomfortable. If y'all against talking reparation, then I'm not against the thought of separation. While the politicians and the white and privilege act highs is different from segregation. That's funny, bro. Segregation is being told where I'm gonna go. Separation is being woke and going wherever I want to go. Okay. So he's talking about if you're against the talk of reparation. Now, reparation is reparation for slavery. You know, talking about the days of when, you know, blacks were enslaved. And reparations, giving them land, giving them property, paying back for what they gave and what they bled and contributed. If you're against that, you know, crooked white politicians, you know, then he relates it to segregation versus separation. I'm not against separation. Now, I'm not talking segregation in terms of, you know, this is black, this is white, because that's not freedom. That's still dividing us and putting us into boxes. What I'm talking about is separation, being woke, being free, being able to go wherever I want to go. That's my own freedom. Oh, back to this hook, man. I gotta point out that line. All them pretty bitches leave your ass in the urn. You know, an urn. We're talking funerals now where you get cremated in and you put your ashes in the urn. That is a heavy, heavy line. I got some more thoughts on this hook, but let's keep going with it. Yes. Oh, I love this percussion, man. It's like distorted. Wow. I'm gonna have to rewind that. But real quick, one more thing on this hook, man, because I am in love with it. I love how the percussion gets louder. And it almost like, it's like a drum roll as the next person is about to take the mic and walk on stage. It's like the percussion built up and Royce came in. Then the percussion built again and it got loud. And then it settled down and the percussion ended. And then M comes in now and delivers his lines. And he already came out of the gate with the wordplay. We're going to have to back this up again. Come on, M. Come on, M. Don't do that to us. Take it easy on us today. Never so dope, full of gold rope. Wanted one though, they were so dope. Was a half knot, cause my pockets didn't have knots. I was so broke. So he's talking about never selling dope on a gold rope. Gold rope, talking about a gold chain. You know, he never sold dope for the gold rope and the gold chain. He wanted one though. Now that could be an ode to, you know, previous hip hop artists who inspired him. LL Cool J comes to mind. Slick Rick, some of those. I think that's where he's going with it. And then he's talking about was a have not because my pockets didn't have knots. Now you see the wordplay there. His pockets didn't have knots. Knots as in, you know, wads of money, but also knots in the sense that his pockets, you know, you put money in his pockets and they just fall through because there are no knots to tie up the money. There's nothing to tie up his pockets. They just fall through. He's got holes in his pockets. Didn't have knots. I was a have not. From a slingshot, better haul ass. There'll be no slowpoke through the tall grass. Run your ass off. Oh no, got your pants caught on the fence. Being chased by them jack boys. Think it's about the fuzz like a lint roll. Let it wait till it's late. They will tiptoe through your living room window. Take a Nintendo and then skate, making you feel like you got bent over and raped. Little boy, you never gonna get rope chain. Get your shit. So this is an interesting picture because we know Eminem is from the other side of the train tracks. We know Eminem is from the trailer park. Who hasn't seen 8 Mile, boys and girls? But he's talking about Whereas a lot of artists will say, you know, I came up from these conditions, but I rose above it. I was stronger than it. I was a jack boy. He's talking about that he used to get picked on by the jack boys. You know, if he had anything nice, if he came out of his struggle, he had that robbed and taken from him. Oh, man.
Get your shit stolen, your lips swollen. I became bitter as I got a little bit older. My hate was making me get colder. Began to get a chip shoulder. Started to spit vogue on my zip code. I've been skit row, but I hate every single beat that I spit over the shithole I escaped.
My zip code have been skit row. I mean, those punches. I've said this before, where he chooses to punch his syllables. It's not just about how this guy writes. It's about how he delivers his lines. And he's so good at these internal rhyme schemes and these complex schemes because of where he punctuates his syllables and where he stresses things. You know, and then obviously shout out Skid Row to LA, one of the famous areas in LA that's extremely broke, an extremely poor area, relating himself to that.
With the shithole I escaped. Then I began to explode, detonate. Now the east side went schizo. Thought my name was B-side because they flipped over my tape.
Nah.
And I won't hesitate.
Oh, because they flipped over my tape. Thought that I was B-side. Calling me B-side, right? Talking about flipped over as in going crazy over it. But at the same time, you know, like the old school cassette tapes, you have an A-side and a B-side. So when you flip it over, you go to the B-side, right? So they flipped over his tape. This man, his mouth has kids, man. He's got crazy wordplay.
Won't hesitate to get him all bent so out of shape. Sit, won't hold up, wait. I just tripped over my cape.
Superman. Wait. Did I just say Superman and he said Superman? Hang on, let me rewind that.
It's so out of shape. Sit, won't hold up, wait. I just tripped over my cape. And I'm not gonna let it
cheat
like I'm chopping a letter dress, tell you I shred.
So Eminem had a very famous song called Superman. If you haven't heard it, I highly recommend it. It's one of his classics. It's definitely Shady.
So when you refer to the guy next to the document shredder.
Wait. I think I just missed something else. Document shredder? I missed something there because I got caught up on that Superman line. Let's bring it back one more time. Alright, here we go.
To get him all bent so out of shape. Sit, won't hold up, wait. I just tripped over my cape. And I'm not gonna let up, treat the paper like I'm chopping a letter dress, tell you I shred. So when you refer to the guy next to the document shredder, now the cops wanna say.
Okay. Dre tells you how I shred. Talking about letters. So he's tearing apart paper. Paper isn't money, but at the same time, when he's shredding letters, you know, like when he spits, he's tearing apart the alphabet. But when you're staring next to the doc, the guy standing next to the doc, you meant shredder. Document. You see how he takes that? Man, the thought process to get there is crazy. So he's shredder, he's tearing apart the paper, but he's playing on document, but he's also playing on doc. Dr. Dre, document.
Roadblocks on my head, I got several bounties from feds in every county. I'm with a gal at a checkers wilding, bumping fuck the police while I fed her rallies. This shit is like
bumping fuck the police while I fed her rallies at a checkers wilding. Okay, all right, rallies, right? That's a Midwest food chain, right? So saying fuck the police, fuck the cops. Another term for police and cops is federales, right? So he's playing on that, but he's got a double entendre meeting while I fed her rallies. Em, you are crazy.
Why do I feel responsible for these kids? All of whom I'm a father to. I'm a god to you. Y'all better worship the water. I walk on it. Y'all gonna meet your Waterloo.
No. Y'all better worship the water I walk on. You remember the song that he came out with when he's walking on water? Worship the water that I walk on. Reference to that song. Or else y'all are going to meet your Waterloo. So he's playing on water. But Waterloo, man, that was a famous battle. Now, I love my history, right? Napoleon. Napoleon was conquered by the Duke of Wellington at Waterloo. That's where he was defeated. So he's saying, you want to battle me, take me on, you go meet your Waterloo.
I get the flipping, the mic is a murder weapon. I'm popping an extra clip and cop and shoot, then I'm popping. Do not let me catch you slipping. I will pop up and I'll take a spot from you. I get to doing what a leaky faucet do, but I ain't talking drip when I say that I'll give the drop on you.
I get to doing like a leaky faucet do, but I ain't talking a drip. You know, drip. I'm not talking about the swagger and the clothes and the materialism and all that stuff, man. We're not flashing. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the drip when I get the drop on you. Like a leaky faucet going drip, drop, drip, drop. Okay,
singing fuck all of you in auto-tune. I am too volatile and too grizzly to bear. Yeah, she's getting to wear. I can barely even sit in a chair. I bust my ass for this shit and
I can barely even sit in a chair. I bust my ass for this shit. He can't sit in a chair because he busted his ass so much. He worked too hard. Caught that line before too. Too grizzly to bear.
Sitting, I swear. It ain't even worth dissing someone so offbeat that they can't even figure out where their word should hit the kick and the snare.
Oh, we gotta take that back. We gotta take that back.
Too volatile and too grizzly to bear. Yeah, shit is getting to wear. I can barely even sit in a chair. I bust my ass for this shit and I swear. It ain't even worth dissing someone so offbeat that they can't even figure out where their word should hit the kick and the snare.
Ain't even worth dissing someone so offbeat. And then you notice that his flow purposefully goes offbeat. Can't even figure out where to hit the kick and the snare. Talking about the snare of the drums, the percussion. Can't even follow a rhythm, a simple drum line. That is a shot at Nick Cannon. That is finally, finally the response that we have been waiting for to Nick Cannon. And you know what the greatest thing about that line is? He still does not even mention Nick. Does not even give him a full song diss track. Doesn't even give him a verse, man. Just gives him a couple lines at the end of a song where he doesn't even mention his name. But that is definitely a shot at Nick. Because, all right, we've all heard the controversy and the beef, right? And we know that Nick's delivery, man, was just trash on some of his diss tracks. I mean, it was obvious the dude just did not follow rhythm very well. The delivery, the punctuation, it just wasn't there. It didn't have it. So M is just making fun of that lack of delivery and that lack of rhythm from Nick. It's like, man, it's not even worth my time. I won't even put your name in the song. I mean, that's another level of dissing someone right there. Man, I could ride with this. So one thing I really, really like about that hook, I know I've said this a number of times now in this reaction, but that hook, man, it goes so well with M and Royce, because M and Royce are two just OGs of hip hop. They're two OG MCs, man. And you have a lot of new artists coming up and people on the come up, right? And that hook is like talking to them. It's talking to the next generation of rappers. And even M's talking about the generation of rappers and people that he inspired and fathered. And it's like, you gonna learn. And it just sets him up. And it's like Royce leading by example, M leading by example, and the hook just ties it all together and talks to the next generation. And it's like, pay attention and take notes. This is how it's done. So Eminem, Royce the 5'9", man, I feel like whenever you guys get on a track, it is going to be fire. Congratulations. You are Knox Hill certified. So if you guys liked today's video, if you did, be sure to smash that like button. Comment down below any other Eminem reactions from this album you want to see me do, or if there's other artists you want to see me check out. I try to read all of your comments, guys. I respond to as much as I can, so please keep commenting and keep posting. Also, don't forget to subscribe with notifications on. It just shows the appreciation, shows the support, helps us get bumped up in the algorithms, man, so more people can find this, more people can join the family, and we can just keep growing. Appreciate you as always, guys. It's a one and only Knox Hill, and I'll catch you in the next one. I'm out.
I be like backing up, backing the dough. They look for the cops and they packing the dope. I am not average, that is for sure. Yeah. I just want you to feel like you relate. My car and my mind are both out of your state. Puppet tape playing the strings, symphony. I break you down over time. Entropy, enemies envy me. Critics, they censor me. Still, I'm the centerpiece. Keep it 100. I'm on my centipede. Rapping for change. I'm on a mission. I buy you out like I'm flipping your business with shit in your kitchen. Sick when it's delivered. See these heights? Neon lights. Green on flight. Shoot me on sight. Otherwise, you gon' regret it. I promise you wanna be holy. I make you Muhammad. Yeah. Me and these rappers got nothing in common. They do it for commas and zeros and fees. I do it for honor. For zeros like me, you do it for cheese. I do it for trees, put you in the dirt. But I want the seeds, heating up like global warming. Holding your ozone, this you want it burn like the Amazon. You are in my forest, I